Hello everyone, my name is Sriram Iyer. I'm an analyst at the Commodity and Currency Research Desk at Reliance Securities. Today I'm going to briefly update you on the gold recap for this week and the outlook for the coming week. So gold prices are on the way for another weekly gain after a choppy trading week. Weakness of the US dollar and subdued bond yields lend support. Initially, prices did correct after the release of Fed monetary policy minutes this week, where the Federal Reserve signaled that a discussion on reducing its bond purchasing program could be soon on the table. The Fed continued to maintain their stance on the inflation, saying that the current price increases, which have led to rising inflation, are likely to only have a transitory effect on the inflation. However, prices recovered despite the Fed taking a slightly hawkish stance on the interest rates, and this lent support to the gold prices during the week. We also believe that the data remained a mixed bag from the US this week and suggests that the US economic recovery appears uneven and possibly will be insufficient to support tapering soon, which is expected, which was spoken by the Fed this week in their minutes. Looking ahead, the prices could continue to move higher or gain traction next week as well, on the back of accommodative Fed and a weaker dollar and subdued bond yields. However, the Fed has made it clear that they will act on the data front, and if data changes, they will change their monetary policy also. So, looking ahead, data might be keenly awaited by investors in the coming week. So on the economic calendar front, we have the US consumer confidence and the US durable goods orders, which will both have a major impact or could have a major impact on prices next week. But however, we do feel that prices could continue to push higher. According to the dot plot from the Fed released in the minutes, there will be no changes in the interest rates throughout 2021. As far as 2022 goes, there were only two voting members that believe that rate should be changed. So we believe that this dovish or accommodative monetary policy stance will keep supporting gold in the medium to longer term horizon as well. So all eyes for next week, I think economic calendar could be the driving factor for gold and silver prices in the next coming week or so. On the chart, spot gold on the international side could see a bullish momentum or could extend its bullish momentum next week technically, as it holds a strong support near 1855 and 1835 levels, and we could see a bounce back from these supports and move towards 1900, and a break above 1900 will push prices towards 1920. On the domestic front, MCX gold June contract could also continue its bullish momentum tracking the international markets, with immediate supports at 48,200 and 47,700. Resistances are at 48,900 and 49,600. But we could see that if the rupee appreciates further going forward in the next coming week or so, tracking the weakness of the dollar, we could see that upside could remain limited for the domestic gold prices. So despite that, we believe the strategy for gold June for short-term traders should be buying on dips near 48,200, 48,250 levels with a stop loss of 48,000 and a target of 48,600 first, and then next target of 48,800. So thank you for listening. Have a pleasant day and a week ahead.